नमः ॐ विष्णु पादाय वेदांत स्वामी
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
Thank you.
So he's described that she said, Namaste Purusham Tvajam Ishvaram Prakriti Param. So he's Purusha, he's a person.
So he's Purusha, he's a person.
But he's Ishvaram Prakriti Param. He's above the material nature. We are under the material nature. But Krishna is above the material nature. And he is also Alaksham. He's invisible to everyone. He is within and at the same time is outside of everything. In the Ishopanishad, there's a verse in the Sri Ishopanishad that Tadejati, Tadnaijati, Tadure, Tadvantike, Jalantarasya Sarvashya, Tadu Sarvashya Vayataha. The Supreme Lord walks, he does not walk. He is within everything and he is outside of everything. He is far away, but he is very near as well. So when these kind of contradictory statements are made, this is to describe the inconceivable potency of the Supreme Lord. So that was the first verse, and then the second verse went on to describe how Lord Krishna is a Hoksaja, that he's beyond the range of the senses.
然后刚刚第一个师姐，现在第二个师姐说到 Krishna 是 Ahojaja， 就是说呢，它是超越感官的感知。
And the example was given is like covered by a curtain of the material energy, the Maya energy.
然后有一个例子讲出来呢，它是被这个能量的这个布幕啊，物质能量的布幕来掩盖着。
And the example was given about an actor on the stage, that the person may be on the stage and he's so nicely disguised and his, everything about him is it's not recognizable that he's playing the part of somebody in a drama, but he's different from the person we know.
嗯，然后还有一个例子说到呢，就像一个演员，他原来的模样呢，由于要上台做出他的角色，所以就化妆啦，更换衣服啦，所以他上了舞台表演，人们认不出他原来的样子。
So in the same way, Lord Krishna comes into this world, but the ordinary people, common people, they're not able to understand the identity of.Lord Krishna.
嗯，那就是说，就像 Krishna 来到这个物质世界出现，可是呢，他对于一般人来讲，无法辨认出他真正的身份，这样同样的情况。
You want to recognize Krishna, you have to have the mercy of Krishna.
嗯，想要把看出 Krishna 来，必须要有 Krishna 的仁慈。
And that mercy of Krishna comes to the people who do service.
嗯，那这个仁慈是由来自于做进行服务的人。
So when we take up some devotional service, then the Lord reveals Himself in proportion to our surrender.
当我们来进行服务的时候，主呢依据我们服务的程度而把他自己相应的揭示出来。
And then the third verse describes the most intelligent woman.
嗯，然后第三个诗节所描述的就是最聪明的女士。
We have intelligent ladies here, PhDs and so on.
我们在座有很聪明的女孩子，得了博士的这些人。
Krishna speaking, Kunti, Queen Kunti speaking about how did she say, how can we women know you perfectly?
所以呢，昆蒂皇后在这边自己叙述，就是说，像我们一般女子呢，怎么能很好完美的来知道你？
Because Queen Kunti describes that Lord Krishna descends.To reveal the science of devotional service into the hearts of advanced transcendentalists.
嗯，因为先前说到呢 ，Krishna 呢，他自己揭示于那超然的超然主义者的心中里面揭示出自己。
Right, Paramahamsa, they're advanced transcendentalists.
这些人是 Paramhamsa， 就是超然、很进步的超然主义者。
Param meaning the supreme, and Hamsa the swan, topmost swan-like personalities.
Param 是至尊 ，Hamsa 就是说天鹅。那最高的天鹅是指那最顶尖、最进步的这些人。
The example is given that the swan can separate.Milk from when there's a mixture of water and milk, the swan can take the milk and leave the water.
是这样子说的。当这个牛奶跟水混在一起的时候，天鹅去到那儿可以把这个牛奶跟水，它可以分出来。
So in a similar manner, the advanced transcendentalists who are like Paramahamsas, they're able to take the spiritual nature of something.And leave the material nature.
所以这些 Paramhamsa 呢，这个是超然的这个最顶尖的超然主义者呢， 他们有这样的能力呢，可以在这个物质跟灵性混浊之中呢，把这个灵性的部分截取出来，把那物质的部分呢抛开。
As it's mentioned here in this verse, that they're purified and they're able to discriminate between matter and spirit.
就如这里所叙述的，就是说这些超然主义者呢，他们已经被净化了。而且他们能够有分辨物质的跟灵性的能力。
So matter means what is temporary and covered with ignorance.
物质的意思就是说，那是短暂、暂时的，而且是被愚昧所蒙蔽的。
But the spirit is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
但灵性的呢，是永恒的，而且是完全喜乐的，充满完全知觉的。
So the transcendentalists not interested in matter, they want to embrace the spiritual nature.
所以超然主义者呢，对物质没有兴趣，他们想要拥抱这灵性的至高的灵性。
And then Muninam, meaning Munis are thoughtful persons, you know, mental speculators, very thoughtful.
那 Muninam, 这个 Muni 呢是指这个思虑周密的人。那这些人呢，他们会想要去推敲思辨。
So usually speculators, they don't have they're not going to come to any real conclusions about the nature of devotion.
因为这些思辨主义者呢，他们呢，并不是真正有确定的这个超然主义的概念，也对找寻绝对真理不见得是绝对的兴趣。
But these munis are very special. They're described as amalatmanam, amala, meaning no dirt in their heart.
而这一类的母女，这些超然主义者很特别。阿玛那母女就是说他们心中没有任何的污秽污染。
So they've got rid of all the lust and the anger and the greed from their heart.
他们的心中呢，所有的物质欲望啦、贪婪啦、愤怒这些品质都从心中清除了。
So because they've purified their heart.Therefore, the Lord is able to give them transcendental knowledge.
由于他们的心灵已经是净化了，所以主呢能够在他们的心里把这超然的知识传递揭示给他们。
So Queen Kunti says, you know, I'm just a simple woman. She said, I'm just a simple woman.How could I ever be qualified like these great transcendentalists and yanis?
这个昆蒂皇后就说，我只是一个女子而已啊，一个妇女，我怎么有办法来了解这个超然真理的这个体旨？
So this is the humility of Queen Kunti.
这是昆蒂皇后的谦卑。
But she's a very great devotee, and we were describing she's really a very special devotee. She's almost on the level of Mother Yashoda.
她是非常伟大的奉献者，非常进步高超的奉献者。我们说到呢，她差不多就是跟 Yashoda 母亲同一个层次的。
And she's come as the aunt of Lord Krishna.
那她成为 Krishna 的这个姑母。这个辈分。
So her next prayer is a very famous one.
这下面的诗节是很有名的。
I think probably all know it, right?
可能大家知道吧。
You can repeat anyway. Krishnaya Vasudevaya.
Krishnaya Vasudevaya.
Deva Kinandanaya cha.
Deva Kinandanaya cha.
祈祷文非常的简单，而且就很容易给他记得的。
So Queen Kunti is describing Lord Krishna. She says, let me therefore offer my respectful obeisances unto the Lord, who has become the son of Vasudev, the pleasure of Devaki, the boy of Nanda, and the other cowherd men of Vrindavan, and the enlivener of the cows and the senses.
昆汀皇后接着这样的说的，让我因此让我向你献上亲近的顶拜主啊，他成为的瓦斯戴瓦的儿子。 而且是Devaki 的快乐，是南达跟其他人们的孩子。Mars, the next page. 其他牧牛人们，那边牧牛人们的孩子，也是这些乳牛跟感官的这个鼓舞者。So
Queen Kunti is offering her obeisances unto Lord Krishna.
昆蒂皇后呢，就是在向 Krishna 顶拜致敬。
When she offers obeisances to Lord Krishna, usually the custom is that you should begin from the lotus feet.
那她就向 Krishna 来致敬顶拜。那一般呢，要向人顶拜致敬呢，是先从她的脚足莲花足开始。And
then gradually come up the body of the Lord. Up to the lotus face.
所以呢，就从脚足开始，然后渐渐往这个身上，然后一直到这个脸啊，就是对主也是这样子一步一步的往上的这样朝拜。
But Kunti, being the aunt of Krishna, it would be embarrassing for Lord Krishna if she would look on his lotus feet.
这个昆蒂皇后呢，她因为是 Krishna 的姑妈，那如果说她要这样顶拜，然后从 Krishna 的脚这样去看的话呢， Krishna 也会觉得很尴尬，不好意思。
So to save Lord Krishna from any uncomfortable situation, Queen Kunti offers, she looks first only at the legs of the Lord. She doesn't look on his lotus feet immediately.
所以呢，昆蒂皇后呢，就帮 Krishna 就说不要让 Krishna 觉得为难，所以呢，她没有先直接看 Krishna 的脚，而是先看着其他的部分，这个像光影这个部分。And
then from the legs, she will look up onto the chest of the Lord, then come to the face of the Lord, and then come back down again and come down to the lotus feet of the Lord.
昆蒂皇后没有直接看 Krishna 的脚，然后就是先她从她的腿，然后往身体上面到她的莲花的脸庞，然后再回过来再看 Krishna 的脚，这样子。
So she's offering her obeisances in that special way because of her very special relationship with Lord Krishna.
所以她是这样的特别的方式在向 Krishna 来顶拜。 而且因为他跟Krishna是有这样特别的关系。So
she describes Lord Krishna, she says, Krishna Vasudevaya. Vasudeva, this word Vasudeva generally is understood to mean the all-pervading.
所以昆蒂皇后的祈祷文先说 Krishna ya Vasudevaya, 这 Vasudeva, 这个原来的，它是指Krishna，那这个意思字意是说，它遍存万有，遍布各处。So
Queen Kunti is identifying who is this all-pervading personality.
所以昆蒂皇后呢，就辨识出，也定义出谁是这个处处都在遍存万有的人。And
she's saying this all-pervading person is Krishna.
所以他说呢，这无所不在的人呢，就是 Krishna.
Lord Krishna appears in three different features: as the Brahman, the Paramatma, and the Bhagavan.
Krishna 出现以不同的展示出现，他以超灵，然后呢，范，然后再来超灵，然后 Bhagavan 这三种阶段的展示。
So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it's described like that. Srila Sutta Goswami was describing the absolute truth, and he said, learned transcendentalists who know the absolute truth, they call this non-dual substance as Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan.
所以在这个瓦坛这个梵歌当中就描述了，就是说，有学问的人在学习绝对真理，而且也知道绝对真理是以这样三个阶段展示出来。 就是以超灵，梵，然后再来是超灵，再来是巴格瓦，这样三个阶段的展示。So
certainly Lord Krishna is the Brahman. Brahman in Bhagavad Gita, you'll see there are many statements where Krishna is speaking about the Brahman.
所以呢 ，Krishna 呢，他这样的展示，他也是这个梵，然后在佛家梵歌里面很多地方有去叙述到这个关于梵。
Brahman is the, it's the impersonal aspect of Lord Krishna.
所以这个本万呢，梵呢，是Krishna的非人格的部分。
And then the Paramatma feature is also described in Bhagavad Gita.
而在佛家梵歌里面也描述到他的超灵的这个状态，在佛家梵歌很多地方有提及。
Krishna will say, "I am in the hearts of all living entities." So in the heart of all living entities, Krishna is there as a super soul, Paramatma.
Krishna 就在佛家梵歌也说了，我处在每个生物的心中，那我是超灵，处在所有生物的心里面。But
he's not only there as a Paramatma, he is also a person, and he's standing there in front of Arjuna and he's speaking Bhagavad Gita.
他不只是生物里面的心中的超灵 Paramatma, 他也是直接一个展示的，他展示自己是人, 直接这样子站在 Arjuna 面前跟他对话。
So it's sometimes difficult for people to understand these different aspects of Krishna. Common people are more attracted to the impersonal Brahman.
So, like Krishna的这个更进步的人格的部分，对一般人来讲是很难了解的。而一般人呢，比较受到Krishna的非人格的部分的吸引。It's
easier aspect to grasp in the beginning.
所以在开始的时候呢。 要去接触到Krishna非人格的部分是比较容易去有概念，比较容易捕捉。
And we think, you know, we could commonly say we think we're all God.
我们常常会看到人们会认为说我们都是神。
Right? People often think like that, that it's all one and we're all one, we're all the Brahman.
很常见到听到人们说，我们大家都是这个合一的一，而我们都是梵。Yeah,
we are all Brahman, right?
我们都是梵吧。
Every living entity is a spark of the Brahman, but what about Krishna? What is his position?
每个生物都是梵，那 Krishna 又是怎么样呢？ Krishna 处于什么地位呢？
Is he also Brahman?
Krishna is Parama.
Huh? Yes, he is a Parabrahman, the Supreme Brahman, right? We are tiny sparks of the Brahman, but he is the Supreme Brahman. A tiny spark of the Brahman can easily be extinguished.
这个饭的一个很微小部分，就像火花，很小火花，很容易被扑灭。Just
like a spark of water, a spark coming from the fire. If it contacts water, it will be extinguished.
就像一丝小火花闪出来，很容易就被水给它扑灭。So
sometimes we hear people say, they give the example about. Oh, it's all one, just like the rivers all flow into the sea and they become one with the sea.
有时候我们也听到人们说，所以一切都是一样，都是一，然后就像各个河流的河水融合起来。
But we say, well, yes, that may be true, but what about the fish in the sea, you know? The fish don't become one with the sea. The fish keep their identity.
那或许你这样说是对的，所有河流汇在一起都是一样的。那么在水中的鱼呢？鱼并没有跟水融合。
In the same way, the living entities may be in the ocean of material existence, but they can be liberated into the spiritual sky.
同样的呢，个体生物呢，在这个物质的存在、物质的海洋生存的，但是他们也可以被提升到了灵性世界、灵性天空。
So Queen Kunti is identifying Lord Krishna as Vasudeva, that he is all pervading.
所以昆蒂皇后就描述 Krishna 是 Vasudeva， 就是说他是无所不在的，处处都在的。
But not only is he all pervading, he's also a very dear son of Devaki and also Nanda Maharaj.
不只是说他无所不在，同时他也是 Devaki 跟 Nanda 大君的亲爱的一个人。
Devaki is the mother of Krishna, the mother of Krishna when he appears in Mathura.
Devaki 呢是 Krishna 的母亲，就是当 Krishna 在 Mathura 出现的时候 ，Devaki 是他的母亲。The
wife of Vasudeva.
是 Vasudeva 的妻子。
But Devaki is also a name for Yashoda.
Devaki 也是同样的跟 Yashoda 名字一样的。
Nanda Nayaka, referring to Nanda Maharaj.
Nanda Nayaka, 同时也是跟 Nanda 大君很亲爱的。
So Lord Krishna gives pleasure to Devaki and to Nanda Maharaj.
所以主 Krishna 呢，同时给 Devaki 也给 Nanda 大君们他们这样的欢乐快乐。
They take great pleasure in Lord Krishna being their child.
他们呢，在Krishna成为他们的孩子的情况里面得到很大的快乐。
And that Nanda Maharaj, Nanda Gopa Kumaraya, the son of Nanda Maharaj, he's a Kumar, he's a young boy.
所以就是 Nanda Gopa Kumaraya, 就是说这 Kumara 就是小孩。 那就是南达这位牧牛人的孩子。
And he's come as a cowherd boy.
他出现是牧牛童这样的情况出现。
He's giving so much pleasure to Devaki and to Nanda Maharaj and the other cowherd men.
他给 Devaki 南达大军啊，还有很多的牧牛人们呢，极大的快乐。
So Queen Kunti is expressing how Lord Krishna is more pleasing than Lord Rama.
所以昆蒂皇后就叙述的，就是说，Krishna是这么令人喜悦的，胜过于这个婆罗诃摩。Lord
Rama has become very popular in India this last 2 years.
Lord Ram, 就是比 Ram 还更加的受人欢迎，但是近两年的印度人呢。 非常的推崇主 Ram，
with the big temple opening in Ayodhya, the birthplace of Lord Ram, there's a lot of interest. People have become more Ram
bhaktas.然后就是说，因为在Ayodhya主 Ram显现的地方呢，那边有一个很大的庙盖起来，那很多人朝圣变成 Ram 的奉献者。But
Lord Rama is always a king, you know. He's not so approachable as Lord Krishna.
但是 Ram 呢，他的身份一直是个国王，不像 Krishna 那么容易接近。Can
you approach a king? Can you imagine approaching the king?
你们可以想象，当你们要去，能不能那么容易去到一个国王那里？
In Thailand, if you go to Thailand, they have a king there. You see. And they have a special language for talking to the king. Whenever you will speak to them, meet the king, you must use this particular, the grammar has to be, but it's very, it's only in addressing the king.
然后现在泰国还是有国王, 那如果说需要, 去见这个国王, 然后跟他谈话的话, 或称呼他呢, 都要有一种特别的敬称, 敬语, 那, 跟他讲的字也, 都有另外一种的字语。
And certainly you have to bow to his feet, you know.
而肯定你也必须要在他的 面前呢，蹲膝跪下。
So we see Hanuman, Bhakta Hanuman, he's always kneeling at the feet of Lord Ram.
我们看到Hanuman呢，他总是跪蹲跪着这个对主Ram来跪蹲着。
One time Lord Rama embraced Hanuman.
有一回主Ram呢拥抱Hanuman。
But that was very, very rare.
哦，这个情况是非常非常的少有罕见。
Lord Rama is always very reverent. He's always in the supreme position. He's above everyone, and people are all kneeling at his Hanuman there at his feet, waiting to serve.
这个主 Ram 呢，总是一直都是高高在上，因为他是一个国王。 啊，周围的人就是对他非常恭敬啊，这样子很小心啊，小心翼翼，很恭敬。And
even as a child, Lord Rama was a prince, and he was the eldest son of his father, so he was always given the greatest respect.
那Ram即便他还是在孩提的时候，因为他是哥哥长兄，啊，又是王子，所以从小大家都对他要很尊重。
Yeah, he was given respect, but he was not so approachable.
是的，他总是受到人们这样的尊敬，但是人们不容易去接近他。But
Lord Krishna, he was born as the son of Vasudeva and Devaki. Now Vasudeva and Devaki, they were also like kings. They were Vasudeva was Kshatriya, and he was a powerful man, a big politician. But Lord Krishna immediately left that home and went to Vrindavan, to the home of Nanda.
Krishna是Devaki跟Vasudeva的儿子，那这个Devaki跟那个Vasudeva他也是国王哈，那总是一副就是说他们的家境就是皇宫都要很威严很尊重。 那Krishna呢受不了，就赶快马上就去到Vrindavan。So
Krishna is much more approachable than Lord Rama.
所以 Krishna 是比 Rama 更容易来接近。
And because he's more approachable, he gives more pleasure to the devotees.
因为呢 Krishna 是更加的容易接近，所以呢，他更多的给了奉献者这一些快乐。
Even there are different aspects of Lord Krishna. We have Krishna in Dwarka and Krishna in Vrindavan.
即便Krishna自己本人呢，也有很多方面的展示，像他在Dwarka跟在Vrindavan呢，他的就是样态心境不一样。There's
a different mood.
他的心境不同。In
Dwarka, Lord Krishna is a prince. And he's wearing royal clothes, and he has all of his wives, and you know, he's in the assembly, sitting on the throne.
那Krishna在Dwarka呢，他是一个国王皇帝，那就这个穿的这个国王的这种华丽的衣服啦、装饰啦，那周围就是他的这些皇后们呐。 臣民们呐，就是一副都很威严的这种情况。So
there's so much opulence there in Dwarka.
那在Dwarka自然就是很富裕的。And
where there is opulence, there will be distance.
然而呢，有富裕存在的地方就会有距离。Just
like in any city, you'll find the very wealthy people, you know, they have some kind of private home, you know, they're they have some security, you won't be able to approach them so easily.
就像呢，在任何的城市呢，都有富有的人家，那他们的家呢，就好像层层围墙啊，那有很好的守卫啦，不能那么轻易的进去啦，防卫的很严谨。
But the common people, you know, their doors are open, you can go there, you can meet them easily.
但是啊，一般人的家里呢，人们好像随时都可以去拜访啦，这样子就可以跟他交流。
So the same way, Lord Krishna in Vrindavan, he's the son of a cowherd family.
所以同样的呢 ，Krishna 在 Vrindavan 呢是一个牧牛人的儿子。
And he's giving great pleasure to all the coward people and all the people in Vrindavan.
然后呢，他给所有的牧牛人啊，所有牧牛童啊，很多的很大的快乐。
At the same time, Krishna, Lord Krishna, is the supreme lord.
同时 ，Krishna 他还是至尊主。
He's the maintainer of the whole cosmic manifestation.
所有宇宙的所有展示都由他来维系的。
So we see, for example, in some tradition, some religious traditions, they will think of God like a father.
我们会看到世界上有一些宗教的传统里面把神呢视为父亲一样。
And being a father.It's a responsibility that you have dependents coming to you.
身为一个父亲呢，就啊扛着责任，就说你有从属的人要去照顾。
Right, you have a father, you go to him, and you know you get some money from him or get what you need from him. You know, you expect to get some kind of shelter, some support from the father.
啊，所以呢，一个父亲是这样，你像你去父亲那里啦，去大那边拿钱啦，或者是要跟他请求什么啦，就是说这个父亲有这个责任要庇护他这些孩子跟从属的人。
And a lot of people they think of God in that way.
而很多人是以这样的方式在想，认为神是这样子。
Yeah. I was brought up in the Christian tradition, and we were taught to pray to God, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Give us this day our daily bread.
我在那个基督教的背景成长里面，我们经常祈祷，就是我亲爱的天主啦，哈，我们在你的庇佑之下啦，我们祈求你给我每日的粮食，每日的面包。
So it's like praying to God to please give me some bread. I need some bread.
就是说，你去跟神说，求你给我一点面包。
So, you know, this is not really a very pleasant business for God.
对于神来讲，这不是很愉快的交易。
Just like being a father, if every day the son or the daughter comes and say, "Oh, Papa, give me some bread."
如果我们想一想说，一个爸爸对他儿子啊、女儿每天去跟他说，爸爸给我一点面包啊，给我给点食物啊。
Yeah. Of course, you know, the father's going to feed you. You know, he's not going to neglect you.
当然，一个父亲会尽职的给你，不会去忽略的。
In the same way, Lord Krishna is the father of everyone. Aham bija pradapita. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, "I am the father of all living entities." He's careful to provide for everyone.
像在《国家梵歌》里面有说的Aham bija，就是说我是所有生给予所有生物生命的父亲，哈。我提供给所有生物所需要的一切。
And he can provide for everyone, even like in so many elephants are there, they eat a lot of food every day.
而且他呢可以提供所有生物的食物，就像也给大象食物，就是大象每天要吃多少公斤的，他也给大象有的吃。
tiny insects, they need to get their grains of food also, they're also provided for.
啊，这些微小的昆虫呢，也需要吃食物。那即便一点点啊，它也一样会提供这些生物都有食物。
So the Lord is taking care of everyone.
所以主是在照顾的每一个人，每一个生物。
You don't have to feel neglected.
不要认为被神忽略了。
But Krishna takes more pleasure.In becoming the son rather than being the father.
然而 Krishna 呢，他啊在身为一个儿子的身份，更加的胜过于说身为一个父亲这样的快乐。
Right, being the child is pleasure. It's nice to have people take care of you and people you can go to cry to and comfort you.
当然当孩子很好啊，你可以去有人呢照顾你呢，提供给你东西啊，不高兴的时候去那边哭一哭啦，他拍拍你的头安慰你啊，多好。
So Lord Krishna also enjoys becoming the son of his devotees.
那 Krishna 也是享受这样，就是说成为他奉献者的儿子。
So Vasudeva is also the father of Krishna. It's not only the all-pervading aspect, but it's also referring to the father of Krishna.
嗯，所以啊，华苏代瓦呢，他不只是遍存万有、处处存在的主，而他同时这个名字也是由于他父亲瓦苏代瓦所延伸的名字。
And he's also the mother is Devaki, and his foster parents are Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda.
嗯，然后他出现为 Devaki 的儿子啊，然后来呢成为 Nanda 大君跟 Yashoda 的孩子这样子。
So Lord Krishna is enjoying these relationships with the, they're his parents and they love him and they take care of him and they want to protect him all the time.
所以 Krishna 就成为他这些奉献者们的孩子啊，然后他们来照顾他啦，给他提供各种服务啊，这些照顾。
Of course, Vasudeva and Devaki, they only got to give birth to Krishna.
嗯，当然呢，对于苏代瓦跟 Devaki 他们的情况，只有就是说把 Krishna 生出来这样一段。
But the childhood pastimes, that was for the pleasure of Nanda and Yashoda.
然而 Krishna 他的孩提时候的这些校园时光，是为了就是给予的南达大君跟 Yashoda 而进行。
Nanda and Yashoda, they're always the mother and father of Lord Krishna.
Nanda, 大君跟 Yashoda 母亲呢，总是是 Krishna 的父母。
And they're the ones to enjoy the childhood leela of Lord Krishna.
而他们呢，就是跟 Krishna 一起在享受 Krishna 孩提的这种逍遥时光。
That's it, the enjoyable part of the parenthood.
就是说他们可以品尝到就是父母可以去得到的那种享受。
Vasudeva and Devaki, they have prayed and they wanted the Lord as their son, but they got the Lord as their son, but they didn't get to enjoy the childhood leela.
嗯，但是瓦苏代瓦跟 Devaki 他们也是祈祷着说让这个主成为他们的孩子，可是呢他们得到这个愿望，但是却没有就是说跟他这个孩子一起的这种逍遥时光。
And later on, Vasudev regretted that, and he understood his mistake that he'd done tapasya to get the Lord as their son, but he should have been thinking about his own liberation.
He thought of his own liberation.
Yeah, Vasudev.
那这个后来呢，瓦苏代瓦。他觉悟了，他知道是自己犯了一个错误，就是说他祈祷着就是说主成为他的儿子，可是呢他那时候这种想法的动机是想要自己得到解脱。
So later on he got association with Narada Muni and Narada Muni could enlighten him.
因为这个动机的存在啊，主这样的安排让他后来去见到 Narada Muni， 那 Narada Muni 来给他启蒙。
So Lord Krishna was enjoying this very much, this being in the cowherd village with all the cowherd people like Nanda and Yashoda and the gopas and the gopis. Lord Krishna was able to relish all of the dealings with these wonderful people, as well as being in the holy land of Vrindavan.
So, Krishna, 可以跟这个他的奉献者这样交流的快乐，就如同跟这个南达大君、耶稣达母亲呐，还有其他牧牛童、牧牛姑娘们在稳达稳一样的情境的。
And he's able to enjoy every day going into the forests of Vrindavan and enjoying the beauty there, and also having many pastimes there.
他可以在文达文呢，每天跟牧牛童们呢一起出去放牛游玩呐，跟这些牧牛姑娘一起嬉戏玩耍啦。
And Lord Krishna is also described here as Govinda, meaning one who gives pleasure to the cows and the senses.
那 Krishna 的名字在这边有一个名字 Govinda， 这个意思就是说。 他是给予乳牛还有感官快乐的人。
So the cows are, and the brahmanas are very dear to Lord Krishna.
所以乳牛跟婆罗门呢， Krishna 是对他们非常亲爱的。
And they're very important parts of the Vedic culture.
而他们是在伟达文化里面很重要的部分。
Cows, of course, provide the most valuable foodstuff in the form of milk.
当然，乳牛呢提供最重要的食物项目就是牛奶。
And milk nourishes the brain. It gives the, it allows the brain to understand transcendental subject matter.
然后呢，牛奶呢，可以滋养我们的脑。 让我们脑力可以得到很好的滋养，而可以来了解这些超然的体质。
We also use milk to make ghee, which is very important for performing yajna.
而且我们也是用牛奶来制成这个酥油，然后这个酥油呢是我们在做祭祀的时候很重要的一个项目。
Ghee, of course, is also very good for cooking. And you can, it's very nice to eat. It's cooked in ghee.
那 ghee 这个酥油呢，也是在烹饪里面是很好的一个用料，就是说它可以把食物煮得非常好的滋味。
Srila Prabhupada used to tell us that oil is meant for the body, for outside the body, but ghee is meant for the stomach.
他爸爸常常说呢。 油啊，这个是做菜这种油呢，是给予身体的各个部分外部，但是呢，酥油呢是给这个胃的。Nowadays,
of course, people use all kinds of oil and different things which they use for cooking.
当然现在呢，就是说用很多各种的油来做饭煮菜。Not
very good for health.
但是那一些对健康并不是很好。There
are temples in India which they have wells which are full of ghee.
在印度有一些庙呢，他们有那个井，但是装得满满的酥油。And
the longer the ghee is kept, the older the ghee is, the more powerful it is.
而这个酥油存放的越久，它的这个力量越强。
So the cows are very, very sacred to Lord Krishna. He himself spent his first 11 years as a cowherd boy.
所以这个乳牛呢，跟Krishna是非常亲近、亲爱的。 Krishna的前面的十一年呢，就是跟牛儿一起有十一年。
We just celebrated a few days ago Gopastami, which is the day in which Lord Krishna grows up and he graduates from taking care of the calves, he starts taking care of the cows.
那前几天我们有说到庆祝这个Gopastami，就是说啊， Krishna 他先前就是照顾这个小牛犊，啊，现在像是毕业了一样，然后开始去照顾这个牛大牛。
Krishna's childhood. In fact, every child, their childhood is meant to be divided into three sections, 5 years of age each.
一个孩子的成长的历程呢, 会分成三个阶段, 就是五岁五年一个阶段。
So, Lord Krishna, of course, he grew up quicker than a lot of children. He was a special child.
当然, Krishna他比其他的孩子所以成长得更快, 因为Krishna是很特别的孩子。
So after 3 years and 4 months, he already graduated like a 5-year-old child.
Krishna在3岁4个月大的时候都已经长得像他的一切就已经像一个5岁的孩子了。
Mm-hmm. So, the first stage is spent at home with the under the care of the mother.
第一个阶段那五年呢，就是在家里有母亲照顾的。
And then the second stage of life, the young boys are sent with the calves, and they go out with the calves in the forest.
然后第二个阶段的五年呢，这小男孩就差不多是5-6岁了，就被派去照顾那小牛儿。
And then the third stage of the childhood, they graduate to the cow.
然后第三个阶段就是10岁之后呢，他们就去照顾这个。
So Krishna had completed 10 years, he was already 11 years old, and then Akrura came and he went to Mathura. But first 10 years of his childhood all spent there in Vrindavan.
所以呢, Krishna前面的10年的孩提时候都是在Vrindavan过的。
Taking care of the cow.
他在那边照顾着这些乳牛。
And also honoring the Brahmanas.
然后也是在那边崇拜的婆罗门。
Right, Krishna in Vrindavan, he has his Brahmana friend. Do you know his Brahmana friend?
Krishna在Vrindavan有那个婆罗门朋友，大家知道他是谁吗？
Madhu Manga. Sudama is in Dwarka.
Dwarka is Sudama. Madhu Manga is his
friend. You know Madhu Manga?
You know Madhu Manga is a special thing?
Fatty boy.
He's a fat kid.
And he will eat Krishna's.
He's always from Krishna's plate to eat things.
Funny pastimes with Madhu Mangal. So Lord Krishna would enjoy with the cows and with the Brahmanas.
所以Krishna呢就很享受跟这些乳牛啦跟婆罗门啦这样一起的快乐。
Cows are very important. Actually, this planet belongs to the cows. The whole planet is actually meant for cows.
那个乳牛非常的重要，实际上这整个星球都是为了乳牛的存在。
If you go to countries like New Zealand, there's so many cows.
如果说去到纽西兰呢，会看到很多很多的乳牛。
And in India, of course, it used to be there were so many cows.
过去在印度也是很多的牛，很多的乳牛。
You go to America, USA, you see huge ranches, so many cows.
然后去到美国呢，很多地方也是一大片草原，很多的牛，乳牛。
Unfortunately, people started, they became so degraded, they started, they thought the cow was meant for eating.
但是不幸的人们 已经堕落，很堕落，就认为牛的是为了杀来吃的。
We see here in Taiwan, you see everywhere, 牛肉面。
Taiwan also many places in the border, the beef noodles.
Very horrible.
很可怕。
But this is something which people have become addicted to, these bad habits.
不知怎么人们就变成沉溺于这些 坏习惯。
But in the past, Lord Krishna, he's Govinda, and he was taking care of the cows and the brahmanas.
但是 Krishna 呢，先前就是这个本达本照顾这些乳牛呢，那也跟所以他的名字也叫做 Govinda.
Every temple has a herd of cows to provide the milk for the deity.
每一个庙里呢，应该有这个自己的牛来提供牛奶啊，制成牛奶制品来供奉给神像。
I heard that the managers of our ISKCON society, they passed a resolution saying they want to provide ahimsa milk for all the deities.
我读到呢，在 ISKCON 的管理部门这个总裁有一个信说到呢，他们呢要这个给 ISKCON 所有的庙宇提供一种非暴力的牛而产生出来的牛奶来供给神像。
Right, that milk in the supermarket, that is not ahimsa milk.
在超市里面买的牛奶呢，并不是说那种非暴力农场所产生的。
Ahimsa milk means the cows are going to be protected.
那个ahimsa 就是非暴力，那就是说这些牛呢是被保护的。
Even after they stop giving milk, they will still be protected.
就是。不只是在牛奶期间，就是说，当这牛老了，不会再给牛奶的时候呢，一样去保护这些乳牛。
And certainly Nanda Maharaj and the other cowherd men in Vrindavan, their cows were all protected.
肯定的，南达大君啊，还有其他的在 Vrindavan 的这些牧牛人们的这些牛呢，都是被保护的。
So Queen Kunti is appreciating how Lord Krishna is known as Govinda.
所以呢，昆蒂皇后就那边就在这个感激的欣赏、赞赏的 Krishna 是这样的情况，所以称呼他 Govinda。
And he gives pleasure. Krishna would give pleasure to the cow.
而且 Krishna 会给这些乳牛快乐。
The cowherd boys they will carry a flute with them to call the cows.
牧牛头们呢，他们都会带着笛子，然后吹着笛子来把牛叫过来。
In the if you read the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, you can read about a cowherd boy from Govardhan named Gop Kumar and how he travels.
所以如果有机会读到这个 Brihad Bhagavatamrita 伟大的国家瓦坦甘露里面呢，里面有一个部分就讲到在 Vrindavan Govardhan 有一个牧牛童叫 Gopal Kumara， 然后里面描述他的旅行的历程。
He was given a mantra by his guru. By the power of the mantra, he could go even into the spiritual world.
那么他的 guru 给他一个 mantra， 一个祈祷咒语，然后他就光这个咒语，他有这个能力去到灵性世界。
But wherever he went, he was in stress as a cowherd boy, with a flute.
不论他去到哪儿，他的衣着都是牧牛童的样子，而且带着笛子。
So wherever he went, people recognized, wow, he's a cowherd boy, he's from Govardhan. They all recognized, immediately they saw him, they would welcome him, that, oh, he's come from Govardhan.
所以呢，这 Gopal Kumara 呢，去到任何地方，人家都看到他这个牧牛童的衣着，然后就想，哦，他是从Govardhan 来的一个牧牛童，大家都很高兴，很赞叹。
And sometimes they would try to get him to change his clothes. They tell him, "Now you've come to Vaikuntha. Why don't you dress like us?"
有时候呢，他被人们说要你干嘛不换了衣服？你现在已经到 Vaikuntha， 为什么不像我们穿的这样华丽等等的
？But Govardhan didn't want to give up his identity as a cowherd boy.
但是 Gopal Kumar 不愿意放弃他是一个牧牛童这样的身份。
He was happy to be a cowherd boy.
他非常高兴他是一个牧牛童。
So Krishna is Govinda.
所以 Krishna 他也是 Govinda.
And the next verse is also a very beautiful verse.
下一个诗节也是非常美的诗节。
And describes the beauty of Lord Krishna.
描述了 Krishna 的美。
The vision of lotuses.
啊，就是莲花族的莲花的视野。
Nama Pankajana Paya.
Nama Pankajana Paya.
Nama Pankajama Lane.
Nama Pankajama Lane.
Nama Pankajana Netraya.
Nama Pankajana Netraya.
Namaste Pankajangraye.
Namaste Pankajangraye.
So when we read this verse, we always remember our dear God brother Pankajangari Prabhu.
当我们在读这个诗的时候，这一节诗的，我会记得啊，就马拉吉的灵性兄弟，这位祭司的 Pankajangari Prabhu.
Pankajangari Prabhu was one of the pujaris in Mayapur,
yeah.
along with his twin brother Janani Bas.
那 Pankajangari Prabhu 呢是 Mayapur 的主祭司跟他的孪生兄弟呢 Janani Bas Prabhu 一起。
So Pankajangari departed from the world a few couple of years ago.
但是 Pankajangari Prabhu 前几年因为疫情确诊而过世。
But he was a very wonderful devotee.
他是非常棒的奉献者。
And we always enjoyed hearing from him. Nice association.
我们一直都很喜欢很快乐的跟他一起的联谊，享受跟他一起的联谊。
So Nama Pankajana Baya, Lord Krishna is being described by Queen Kunti that she says, I offer my obeisances unto the Lord whose navel is marked with the depression of a lotus flower.
所以昆蒂皇后继续献上她的祈祷，就是说我们像这个肚腹上画的莲花的这位主我们向他顶拜。
Right? Panka means mud, and ja means born from. So the lotus flower is born from the mud.
Panka 就是这个土，泥土这个土 ，ja 就是出生，就是说像莲花呢，也是从泥土土而这样生出来。
So, Garbo Dakshayi Vishnu, Lord Garbo Dakshayi Vishnu is laying on the Garbhodak ocean in each universe, and from his navel comes up a lotus flower.
就像 Garbhodakshayi Vishnu 孕蛋滋养尾丝牛呢，他躺在孕蛋的海洋，然后呢，在他的肚脐呢长出莲花。
And then from that lotus flower comes Lord Brahma.
然后从他的莲花顶上呢，这个 Brahma 出现出生了。
And Lord Brahma is the first living entity in each universe.
Brahma 呢，婆罗诃摩梵天呢，是每个宇宙的出现的第一个生物。
So Queen Kunti is respecting Lord Krishna as being non-different from this Garbhodakshayi Vishnu.
所以呢，昆蒂皇后就在描述的 Krishna。就是这个孕蛋滋养尾丝牛 Garbhodakshayi Vishnu.
And then she offers, she said, Nama Pankaja Malane, that I offer my obeisances unto the Lord who is decorated with a garland of lotus flowers.
然后昆蒂皇后继续说的，我向那个主呢，他总是由这个莲花串成的花环，带着莲花串成的花环的这位主来顶拜。
Lord Krishna, is decorated. I nice to have a nice garland of lotus flower.
Krishna 的这个衣着装扮呢，常常就是那个很美的这个莲花串成的花环，这样带着。
We try to grow lotus flowers in Mayapur for the deities there.
在麦阿普那边的庙呢，也试着种那个莲花，可以来为神像啊做这个服务。
The lotus flower is very dear to Lord Krishna. He likes them very much.
莲花跟 Krishna 也是非常亲近亲爱的，因为 Krishna 非常的喜爱莲花。
And the lotus leaf is also very nice.
啊，莲花的这个叶子呢也非常好。
Just like you can eat from the banana leaf, you can also eat from the lotus leaf.
就像香蕉，香蕉的叶子也可以来吃食用的。那莲花还有莲花的叶子一样都可以食用的。
They're both these kind of leaves are waterproof.The water doesn't become absorbed by them. The water rolls.
像莲花叶子呢，都是防水。你看它那个水滴穿不过去，就一颗水珠水珠嘛的。
So if you don't have your plate one day, you can simply find a lotus leaf.
哪一天你没有盘子的时候，你去找这个莲花的叶子当盘子。
And you can take your food.
然后把这个莲花叶当作你的盘子来盛装食物。
So Lord Krishna likes the garland with the lotus flowers.
所以 Krishna 喜欢呢莲花这个串成的花环。
And then Queen Kunti says, "Namo Pankajane Traya, that his glance is as cool as a lotus flower."
啊，昆蒂皇后又说呢。那么庞克加耶内特拉雅就是说 Krishna 的这个眼视野的瞥视呢是非常让人凉爽的，就像莲花那样的清凉。
Different parts of the Lord's body are compared to the lotus flower.
主的身体的很多每个部分都被比喻成莲花的各个部位。
Right, he has lotus eyes.
我们说 Krishna有莲花般的眼睛
，and then
lotus face 莲花般的这个脸庞
，lotus， 所以都是莲花。Yeah, we have lotus feet, lotus face，
莲花手
，the hands, lotus hands， yeah， and， huh？Lotus eyes, yes,
lotus.
And then the navel also.
And then the 肚脐，莲花般的肚脐。
The different parts of the Lord's body there compared to the lotus flower.
所以啊，克夏的身体的各个部分呢，都以莲花来这样的描述的。
And then Namaste Pankajangraye, that is.Lotus feet are marked with the impression of lotus flowers.
Namaste Pankajangraye. 就是说，主呢，他的莲花足有这个莲花的这个标志。
Lord Krishna always walked without shoes.
Krishna 都是赤脚走路，不穿鞋。
It's nowadays very difficult to walk in the holy dam without shoes.
但是现在呢，在圣地要说赤脚走路也很难的。
Some people can do it.
有一些人是能做得到。
The roads are, you know, they become so, the surface is not easy for walking on.
They make this a tar.
Yeah.
现在都很多铺的柏油，然后有小石头尖尖的，不好赤脚。
And of course, in Vrindavan, there's always thorns and different sharp stones on the ground.
而在本达文那个有一些路还是有那个尖锐的小石头啦，或是不小心会有树枝枝干。
If you chant the Gopi Geet, in the Gopi Geet, the Gopis pray to Lord Krishna. They pray.Oh, we're worried about your lotus feet. You're walking on all these stones and thorns. It must be painful for you.
如果大家读那个 Gopi Gita 这本这些诗集呢，就是说牧牛姑娘的这个歌曲对 Krishna 的描述，就是说他们担心 Krishna， 就是哎呀，亲爱的 Krishna， 你都赤脚走路，我们很担心你被那个地上的石头啊、树枝刺到你的脚而受伤。
So even 5,000 years ago, there were difficulties walking in the forest.
所以即使5000年前要赤脚走路也是很不容易、很难的。
when Akrura came to Vrindavan, he was sent, Akrura had been sent from Mathura by Kamsa, and he was told to go to Vrindavan and bring Krishna and Balaram. Mm.
当时呢，啊，阿库拉由康萨所派呢，从马图拉去到文达本，要来带着克什纳跟巴拉拉米一起走。
So Akrura came to Mathura and he saw the footprints of Lord Krishna on the ground.
那阿库拉来，那就看到这个地上有这个克什纳这个莲花族的脚印那个痕迹。
How did he know they were the footprints of Lord Krishna?
那他们，他怎么知道那些脚印是克什纳的？
Because the different auspicious markings which are on the lotus feet of Krishna.
因为呢，Krishna的脚底呢有不同的这个，还有包括莲花的这种所谓这个标志，那它会印在这个地上。
Especially, of course, the lotus flower.
在Krishna脚底下的各种标志呢，特别是这个莲花也明显。
My respectful obeisances are unto you, O Lord, whose abdomen is marked with a depression like a lotus flower, who are always decorated with garlands of lotus flowers, whose glance is as cool as a lotus, and whose feet are engraved with lotuses.
Here, the depression,
general feeling of depression or aluminium. 而且总是主呢，Krishna总是挂着这莲花所串成的花环，然后他的眼睛的瞥视就像莲花一样的清凉，他的脚总是有着莲花的标记。So
we see from this wonderful prayer a very nice descriptions about the features of the Lord.
所以从这些祈祷，我们可以知道呢。 Krishna，就是怎么样的描述出Krishna他那么美丽的这身体。
In other religious traditions, you know, people may speak about God, but they have no real description about him.
但是在其他宗教，人们也会提到神，但是他们没有对神的一些比较实际清楚的描述。
They have no information about his activities, what he's dressed, what he's acting doing.
他们呢，没有讯息可以得到说知道神他是什么样子，他穿什么，怎么样的衣服，他的活动，他在做什么。
I was in the Philippines some years ago, and Tamal Krishna Goswami was there, and he met with the cardinal from the Roman Catholic Church. There was one cardinal, a Filipino cardinal, his name was Cardinal Sin.
S-I-N?以前呢，我曾经去过菲律宾，当时Tamal Krishna Maharaj也在那儿，那么呢，我们去跟一个 教会里面的主教去会面，那个主教名叫做Singh，教皇Singh。
He was a cardinal. It's a very big position in the Catholic Church.
他是一个主教，在天主教里面是很高位的人。So
Tamal Krishna Maharaj arranged a meeting with him. And he had a lot of questions to put to him.
那么Tamal Krishna Maharaj 呢，就安排一个会面，然后呢。 这个主教呢，跟他提了很多的问题。And
he wanted to know from him. He wanted to know, in your tradition, what is God doing in the kingdom of God?
What are his activities? 那个主教呢，也想知道，然后就问说，哎，在你们的传，就是我们哈，你们的传统里面，你们知道神他在做什么？神的活动是什么？And
what are his uh, How does he appear? How does he dress?
然后又说，哎，你们说的那个神啊，他出现的样子长得什么样子啊？
But,
啊，他做什么啊？这些。
But the cardinal would simply say, "No, no, we don't have it. We don't have this information in our tradition." 啊，
那他们克什马拉姐这样问他，那个主教就说，哦，关于神的什么长样子啊、活动啊，我们没有资料，我们没有讯息。
They have not any other religious tradition. They have no information about these things.
所以呢，其他的宗教对于神的这个人格的特征啊、活动啊，没有讯息。
But we see in the Vedic scriptures, there's a lot of information.
而我们见到伟达的经典呢，有非常多的讯息。
We get a lot of descriptions about the kingdom of God and what's going on there.
而且呢，我们呢又获得了很多的关于神的王国啦，啊，神的王国是长什么样子啊？啊，里面怎么样做什么活动，都有很多的描述。
You can read in the Srimad Bhagavatam how the four Kumaras entered into the spiritual world.
啊，可以来读这个《圣莲佛教瓦坛》啊，里面也有说四个 Kumara 这四个小孩呢，他们怎么样进到了灵性世界。
And if you read the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, you get very elaborate, detailed information about what's going on there in Vaikuntha.
那如果来读伟大的《薄伽瓦坛甘露》呢，可以更多的知道呢，在灵性世界Vaikuntha里面的更多的细节。
And even more detailed information about Goloka.
而且更多关于 Goloka 的讯息。
So Queen Kunti is describing her loving appreciation of Lord Krishna.
所以昆蒂皇后呢，就在描述她跟 Krishna 之间亲爱的关系。
And by this prayer, she's making it very easy for all of us to be Krishna conscious.
而凭借着啊昆蒂皇后的这些祈祷文呢，啊，我们可以很容易的去知道，去接触到 Krishna 之觉。
Whenever you see a lotus flower.We'll be reminded of Krishna.
啊，所以当我们见到这个莲花的时候呢，我们很容易去记得 Krishna.
Actually, everything that we in this world is meant to remind us of Krishna.
实际上这世界的所有一切都是来提醒我们来记得 Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada went to Jakarta, Indonesia, and he met one man there. It was an Indian man.And the man said to Prabhupada, he said, Swamiji, I like Krishna, but I also like wine.
Prabhupada 有一次去到印尼的雅加达，然后遇到有一个人，那个人跟 Prabhupada 说，哎呀，我喜欢 Krishna, 可是我也喜欢喝酒。
So Prabhupada told him, he said, well, he said, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita,Rasoham Apsukunti. I said, I am the taste in liquids. So he said, whenever you drink this wine, you should think this wine, this is the taste of Krishna.
Prabhupada 跟他说，啊，Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》里面说，我也是各种液体的滋味啊，品味。所以每当你喝一口酒，你就去想到 Krishna， 你要记得这也是 Krishna.
So.And Prabhupada told him, he said, if you will think like this, then very quickly you will become Krishna conscious.
Prabhupada 又跟他说呢，如果你这样子来想的话，你很快的就成为 Krishna 知觉的了。
We have to see everything in relation to Krishna.
我们必须把一切都看到是跟 Krishna 有关系的。
Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Aham Sarvasya Prabhavam Akasa Vampavartate.I am the source of everything, material and spiritual.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》里面有说了呢，我是所有一切的源头，是所有一切灵性跟物质的起源。
So everything that you see has its connection with Lord Krishna.
所以所有的一切我们看到的所有一切呢，跟 Krishna 都是有关系的。
Of course, not everything is as beautiful as a lotus flower.
当然，并不是所有一切都跟莲花那样的美。
The lotuses, they have a special connection with Lord Krishna.
莲花有一个跟 Krishna 特别的关系的。
But still, everything in this world, it is Krishna's energy.
但是呢，啊，在世界所有一切都是 Krishna 的能量。
It's meant for the service of Krishna.
嗯，而是为要来服务 Krishna 的。
Just like the lotuses, the lotus flowers, they're meant for the service of Krishna.
啊，就像莲花呢，也是要来服务 Krishna 的。
Prabhupada says, in the material world, a man has a flower, he will give the flower to his wife or to his girlfriend.
婆婆说呢，在这个世界上呢，如果一个男士呢有了花的话呢，他会把这个花给他的老婆或是给他的女朋友。
And the devotee, he will give it to Krishna.
而奉献者有了花呢，会给 Krishna.
So Queen Kunti, because she's a devotee,She's seeing the beauty of Krishna. She's appreciating all these lotuses, how they're all decorating Krishna.
啊，因为皇啊，昆蒂皇后是 Krishna 的奉献者，所以呢，她就想到 Krishna 的各种美，然后去感激啊，赞叹他 Krishna 的美。
So this is a very nice verse. Again, these two verses very special in the prayers of Queen Kunti.
嗯，所以呢，这是非常美的诗呢，啊，也是这个昆蒂皇后所献出来的。
You can remember these two verses very easily, very simple, so easy to remember.
我们可以很容易来记得这个两个诗节啊，因为它里面的字句很简单。
I remember as a young devotee, we were on the streets, and we would sing this on the streets when we would do Harinam Sankirtan.
我记得我还是年轻的奉献者，那时候呢，我们去街上唱诵呢，我们会唱着这个祈祷文。
We would feel very joyful chanting.
我们唱着这个会是非常欢喜这种情境。
Any question? Anybody?
How is the melody of this?
Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devakinandanaya cha Nanda Gopal Komaraya Govindaya Namo Namah Namo Pankajana Paya Namo Pankajamalini Namo Pankajanetraya Namaste Pankajandraye Simple Any question, anyone?
Maharaj, Hare Krishna.
Yes?
You just mentioned about the wine and the Indian wine jungle. So Krishna mentioned that Krishna is the taste in wine. So how, because he is taking wine, and Prabhupada told him that you can feel that Krishna is the taste in the wine. But in reality, by taking wine, he is getting more intoxicated. I'm degraded. So how he is Krishna conscious?
因为刚刚有提到那个印度人，他说他喜欢喝酒，那但是婆婆跟他说呢，当你在喝啊，因为婆家梵哥说到 Krishna 还是各种的滋味，包括酒哈。那如果这个人他喝了酒，不是更加的，所以这个脑筋昏沉呢？那这样子他又要想到 Krishna， 但是他这样怎么成为 Krishna 知觉？因为醉酒的话。
Now we have to understand the effect of remembrance of Krishna.
啊，我们必须要来了解，来记得 Krishna 的效力。
We start to remember Krishna, thinking of Krishna.
就是说我们要开始来想着 Krishna， 开始来记得 Krishna。
Then that has a purifying effect.
这种去记得、去想着 Krishna， 就有这个净化的力量。
Just like Bilba Mangal, you know the story of Bilba Mangal, right?
就像那个 Bilba Mangal 这个故事。
Right, Bilba Mangal, he came to see his girlfriend Chintamani, and she said to him, "Oh, you're so eager to see me. If only you have the same eagerness to see Krishna."
啊 ，Bilba Mangal 后来迷恋的那个女孩子 Chintamani， 那么请他们，你看他这样不辞风雨，不辞这个路上艰辛，一路都过来看他。那这个请他们跟他说，哇啊，你这么依恋我，也不计一切的来看我。如果你对主有同样这样的坚持跟热忱的话，那会多好啊。
So in the same way, the Indian man, you know, I mean, don't know if he ever became a devotee, but you know, Prabhupada did give that instruction. It was recorded.
那啊，那个印度人，我不知道他后来是不是成了奉献者，但是这有记录，就是说 Prabhupada 给他的训示是这样：即便你是喝酒啊，也是来想着 Krishna.
Yeah, Krishna doesn't say in the Bhagavad Gita just only water, but he, you know the.Rasoham apsukunti or rasa. It can be any kind of liquid.
So Krishna 不仅是水的滋味，水的芳香。那 Krishna 是所有一切的滋味啊，所以一切的滋味芳香都是 Krishna.
And if somebody actually does try to remember Krishna, then you know eventually that remembrance of Krishna will.Lead them away from that. He will realize that I shouldn't be drinking all this.
因为如果一个真心的想要去记得 Krishna 的话呢 ，Krishna 会让他有这个力量去啊努力去记得他，而自然会放弃他。他会觉得啊，就会放弃那些习惯，就会觉得那些实在是自己不应该去做的事，或是微不足道的东，微不足道的衣服。
Maharaj, probably because Prabhupada thought if he tells him to give up wine, he won't do it. So it's better to drink and remember Krishna. if he tells him to give up completely, you know, he won't give up immediately.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
他说到了 Prabhupada 如果叫那个人就说直接不要喝酒，那个人肯定不会，一定会拒绝。所以呢，就用这个方式让他哎还可以喝酒，但是要记得 Krishna， 就用这种诱导。
Yes. Sometimes people they need that, you know, little, and you know, a little mercy just to help them become Krishna conscious.
有时候人们就需要有那种仁慈哈、啊，来帮助跟他合并的习惯，来得到仁慈。
So, in that particular case, Prabhupada was giving some mercy.
所以在那个情况是蛮特别，婆婆给他一些仁慈。
Not always.
并不总是啊这样子来做的。
Just like there was that one devotee, he wanted to get Prabhupada's watch. He wanted to steal Prabhupada's watch.
曾经有一个奉献者，他想要去偷 Prabhupada 的表，手表。
Yeah. And the devotee was always waiting for the chance to steal Prabhupada's watch.
跟那个奉献者一直在等个机会，想要找机会去偷 Prabhupada 的手表。
And Prabhupada said, "Yeah, take my watch."
对，婆婆发现了，就说：“好吧，哎，这个表你拿去吧。
”And so the devotee was so overwhelmed, he became, you know, he's still a devotee, he's still there with Krishna.
那个奉献的当然是很震惊啊，他的老师给他这样的，所以他后来就继续成为奉献者，他很感。很感动，对吧？现在仍然是个奉献者。
我有两个问题，第一个是用酥油，他说酥油放越久，力量越强大，这个是第一个问题。然后第二个问题是，他说 Vasudeva 他要孩子的时候，他并没有那时候并没有想要解脱，那个。
没有，他怀着解脱的动力。
他是怀着解脱的动力。为什么是怀着解脱的动力
？OK， 两个。She has two questions. First one is mentioning about the give. To store it the longer, the effect is stronger. She doesn't know how the mechanism. And second is Vasudeva couldn't have the only deliver Krishna, but not having the
our childhood pastimes together. So because we just mentioned, because he has a desire for liberation, that's the idea. And why he cannot get like Yashoda, they have a together with Krishna.
Vasudeva，因为在那个经典上，Vasudeva他怀着，因为他是第三次出生嘛，他第一次是苏帕达，然后他的太太是那个普瑞斯尼嘛，第二次的时候他是变成卡夏帕跟那个阿迪提他们夫妻，然后第三次他是Vasudeva，然后因为他之前在苏帕达的时候，他做了12000年的天堂星球的那个苦修。 然后他是要为了想要一个孩子，可是他那时候只吸空气跟吃掉落下来的树叶干树叶，可是为什么他那时候他只是要苦修，他只是想要一个 Krishna 的孩子，他并没有想要解脱，所以 Krishna 才愿意给他当孩当小孩。可是老师刚说，他要小孩是因为他有个错误的观念，是因为他要解脱，所以这两个是有点。
奇怪，不是说他要解脱，他也有解脱的愿望，不是为了小孩而解脱，他同时有。
No,
I think you translated wrong when Mara spoke. That's why she's confused now.
No, clarify again. Yeah. So first about the cow ghee.
Well, the cow ghee, yes, the longer you keep it, the more powerful it becomes.
就是那个牛的乳牛那个牛奶的酥油放的越久，它越有效力。
But there shouldn't be any impurities in it, you know. It should be the very purity.
酥油是非常纯净纯洁的，放很久也不会有污染。你问为什么？
对啊，为什么？
But that's just the way it is. That the longer you keep it, the more powerful it becomes.
这是酥油的本质，放越久，它自然越有力量。
Just like they have wines also. You know?
Vasudeva的那个课文讲的有点不太一样。Marge, if you can help us to illustrate more about Vasudeva Devaki, they have a Krishna as a child, but not as Yashoda, Nanda, they have a. 对，其实他是要解脱。问他为什么他，因为他。为什么不需要解脱？对他课本上是写他没有要解脱，可是老师说他是因为一个。They
have a Krishna together in the childhood pastime, but Vasudeva Devaki they don't have.
Vasudeva and Devaki, yeah, they did the tapasya to get the Lord as their child.
Vasudeva Devaki, they also did苦行，想要祖传他们的孩子。
Wanted to give birth to the Lord as their child, but they didn't get to have the childhood pastime.
但是他们没有得到跟主在一起那个。Because
the childhood pastimes are only with Nanda and Yashoda.
那个孩童的时光只有跟南达大君跟亚修达他们一起。Nanda and Yashoda,
they have a higher love than Vasudeva and Devaki.
因为南达跟亚修达他们比Vasudeva的爱更高。
Vasudeva and Devaki, they are Krishna's parents in Dwarka.
Vasudeva and Devaki, 他们是 Krishna 在Dwarka 的父母。
And Mathura.
而且是在马杜拉，而不是在本沙文。In Mathura, Vasudeva and Devaki are offering prayers to Krishna. 因为他们把 Krishna 当作神，是这样高位的。But
Nanda and Yashoda, they never think of Krishna as God.
但是南达跟亚修达不会把 Krishna 当作神。They
only think of him as their child.
他们只把 Krishna 就是当作就是自己的孩子。So
that love, that's a greater love.
所以是因为这个爱的 这个更高更大。
We're singing about that in the Damodar Astikam prayer every time.
就像我每次都在唱诵这个主达摩达尔这个八赞歌。
It says that the Lord is not, he doesn't give himself to those people who worship him with awe and veneration.
这里面描述就是主不会揭示自己给那对他怀着敬畏之情的人揭示出来。
But he is attracted by the intimacy, the pure love and devotion without the veneration which is offered by his pure devotee.
他受的他纯粹奉献着纯粹的爱没有那种敬畏哈恐惧之心的奉献者。
So that is given by Yashoda and Nandamara.
所以因为这个缘故所以他这段消息光是给这个南达跟 Yashoda.
Not Vasudeva.
不是 Vasudeva and Devaki.
So Krishna enjoys being chastised by Mother Yashoda.
就像享受被 Yashoda 母亲来责骂。
He enjoys the father chastising him.
可以想享受也是他的父亲来责骂他这些事情。
Just like Lord Chaitanya's father, Jagannath Mishra used to chastise Nimai Pandit.
就像主持人他之前的像时光的说他也是接受他父亲的 Jagannath Mishra 对他他小时候叫Nimai跟他责备父亲责备孩子。
So sometimes Brahman would come in the dream of Jagannath Mishra and the Brahmana would say you should not talk to your son like that.
有些时候婆罗门们呢他们会去到 Jagannath Mishra 这边然后 跟他说你不应该对你的孩子这么讲话。
Because you don't know who your son is.
因为你不知道你的儿子是什么身份。
But Jagannath Mishra would say, well, I'm his father, he's my son.
但 Jagannath Mishra 说我是他的父亲他是我的儿子。
My duty to chastise him.
我的责任就是应该要来责备、责骂他。
I don't care who he is.
我不管他是谁。
谢谢老师。
Okay. All right. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah. Yeah.